Right, today we're here with Race by Design with a new product called VentureShield to protect your helmet. Can you just tell us what the product does?
Yep, it's a clear polyurethane material, so it's virtually invisible, and it protects paintwork on your helmet from stone chips and damage, which obviously nearly everybody gets annoyed with, and that's why we produced it.
So what's the background behind the product?
Well, VentureShield started quite a few years ago, originally to protect rotor blades on helicopters in Iraq, because they were finding they're getting quite damaged, and that's where it originated from. Most people know it nowadays for protecting the bumpers and bonnets on their cars. Dealerships around the UK fit them to cars and to road bikes. Certain manufacturers of motorbike have their own parts which they supply direct to the dealerships, which is VentureShield. We mainly deal with the two-wheel motorsport division. We fit to race bikes purely, and from that we produced and developed the helmet kits.
Right. Tell us a bit about the polyurethane as well. What, you know, because it's quite a advanced bit of technology, really.
Yeah. The material itself, as you'll see from the kit here, it's virtually invisible on the backing piece. If you peel it off, it's almost optically clear as it is there. Once it's placed on a helmet, it is optically clear. You can very finely see an edge on a plain helmet. Strength-wise, I mean, it's only 150 microns thick, but it takes over 20 pounds of pressure in one point for it to actually burst through the material.
Okay.
When it's on a surface like a helmet, it's obviously a lot stronger because it's got something to sit on. It stretches four times its own size. You can't really stretch it to that size itself, and to try and tear it between two people is almost virtually impossible.
Right. So how do you fit it?
The kits themselves, there's always two pieces in the standard road bike kit or road helmet kits. You get the top piece, which fits around the crown of the helmet, which yep. goes up there, and you have a chin piece on the smaller part of the kit, and that fits around the bottom part of the helmet,
yep.
not incorporating the air vent,
because right.
That's a separate piece, the actual shell of the helmet. So we're actually protecting all the paintwork rather than the plastics, which are mainly replaceable on helmet kits. From there, the instructions are all contained inside. You get a bottle which has a very small amount of solution inside. This allows the material to move around when you're applying it.
Right.
You just fill that up with water from your tap, and it comes with a squeegee. The squeegee allows you to press the water and the fluid from and the air bubbles out from underneath the helmet kit. And once that's done, the adhesive then is onto the helmet. And that's pretty much it.
So if you go wrong, you can take off and do it again?
Yeah, you can. The good thing about VentureShield is it's not like a transfer like for your bikes or your helmets that some people put on their helmets. If you make a mistake and you get a crease or a bubble or it's in the wrong position, you can just peel it off again, making sure your hands and the material are wet, and you can just reapply and start again.
Right, okay. So run us through, just show us quickly how to fit it on.
The best way to do it is always find yourself a nice comfy chair, place the helmet between your legs, because you can grip with your knees,
yeah.
It leaves your hands free to do the job. You get your solution, which is in the bottle. Obviously, fill it right to the top. This one I've been using.
Yeah, any water, just tap water.
Just tap water. Just plain old tap water. Don't have to be anything special, unless you want to obviously use something out of a bottle. But
right.
You just spray it across the front. Make sure that you obviously remove the visor from the helmet first, because it means you don't get that soaking wet. You then grab the material itself and peel it off the backing paper, and once the material's off, you just coat that with the solution, and then you place that over the top and centralize it roughly. It doesn't have to be exact where you're going to fit it on the helmet. Now, the starting place for a chin piece was always, we use the left hand side, because you've got the aperture there, which is for the pin on the visor,
yeah,
and that always stays the same, so it's never really going to change. So between the vent and that aperture there, the piece comes up in the centre. Always use that as a medium to get yourself started. And then once that's done, you coat the surface with some more fluid. And grab your squeegee, and with a firm bit of pressure, but not too hard, because what you don't want to do is score the material on top and mark it with rubber. You just squeeze the water out and the air bubbles from underneath, like that. So basically going from top to bottom, working out from the centre to the outside edges. And then once that piece is fixed, you can then move the kit round. You can hold on to this piece, stretch it slightly, making sure that the line across the bottom is matching the bottom of the helmet. Just work the water and the solution and the air out from underneath, like so. And the same with the other side. If you keep the side you've done away from you, it allows you then to pull the material to stretch it. And once it's stretched, and again you've got that medium line across the bottom, you just match up this edge where the air vent is. Again, just working small bits at a time. You don't have to do the whole thing at once. Just nice and slowly.
And if you go wrong?
If you go wrong, I mean that's done now.
Yeah.
If you do go wrong and you've made a mistake and it's too high in one place, or you've got an air bubble somewhere, as long as you keep the material and your fingers a little bit wet, then all you do is you pick a corner, peel it back up, and you start again. Just making sure that you obviously keep everything nice and moist, because what will happen is if the solution vanishes from underneath, so if we take away the solution and you go to stick it down, it'll instantly stick, so you won't be able to move it around. You won't be able to get the air bubbles out. So again, when you peel it back and you want to start again, just make sure the helmet's wet, the material's wet, put it back down, give it a stretch, make sure everything lines up. Just squeeze the water out from underneath. Make sure all the air bubbles are gone.
So I'm right in thinking this product's available for Arais at the moment.
Yep.
And also being made for more helmet manufacturers.
At the moment, the range is for Arai, Corsair, Viper, and the Astro, in all sizes. They will be kits available soon for the Shoei XR1000 and the X Spirit. They're $24.99 for the kit, which comes complete as you've seen, and obviously fitting it is a doddle, and obviously saves you a lot of damage to your helmet.
And whereabouts can you get it from?
Well, the distributor for Europe for the kit itself is from Phoenix Distribution, who are obviously Arai's distributor as well, but they will be doing the complete range of kits. And you can basically get their contact details at yarai.co.uk.
Right. Thank you very much.
Yeah, pleasure.